In the next section, let us take a look at valuations and portfolio positioning. With the country seeing lower than average bond yields, and which we expect to sustain, we do expect in turn that higher than average PEs would sustain. Now, as we have been pointing out over the past 2 months, we do expect markets to attain their highs with continued expansion of the economy back to normal levels. We expect financial year 22 earnings to be significantly higher than the expectations pre-COVID financial 20, and expect markets to reflect the same and reattain earlier highs over the next few months, and yes, supported by lower interest rates. As yet, Indian markets is primarily driven by non-institutional money. Domestic institutional investors actually have been net sellers. FIIs have been buyers. It is the retail participation at the bottom of the market that has been a big positive and has also helped improve the breadth of the market. We do believe that as markets normalize and as distribution channel is able to go back to the clients, even domestic institutional investors like mutual funds would start to see inflows. Now, foreign portfolio investors have been buying and their flows are getting stronger. August flows are sharply above July flows. Participation in new fundraising initiatives by India Inc. in general and financial sector in particular has been the route for investment by the foreign investors. We do believe this trend to be maintained on account of a very high global liquidity situation. In terms of sectoral choices, we believe sectors which are negatively impacted by the current situation and can stay impacted for longer could see stagnation in valuations at lower levels. The winners emerging from this situation, such as technology and pharma, consumers and chemicals, are already doing much better. Agri space, you know, the full ecosystem, seeds, insecticide, pesticide, even implements, vehicles like tractors and by extension two-wheelers, have the support of good rains and better crop area. Now, home improvement categories could also do much better. You know, staples should continue to see stable growth. These trends were seen in quarter one numbers. We managed to select well, and in general, our selections delivered much better growth versus the market as a whole. Most of our portfolios, in terms of portfolio wide earnings, saw a degrowth of 10-15% versus a Nifty degrowth of 25% and a broad market degrowth of over 40%. In times like these, we do expect people to buy home appliances to make homes more comfortable. Now, low-tech spaces, you know, like ceramics, laminates, sanitary ware, etc., may actually see some strong export demand as well. Now, interest rates are low around the world, and the people in many parts of the world are buying new houses, refurbishing their houses to take advantage. And these categories would be required. So while in the past these were not large export categories, we do believe there is a chance that businesses in these spaces see a strong export demand. Lower interest rates would benefit autos as well. autos would be bought also more to maintain social distancing while traveling to office. Some of these trends are seen globally as well. In financing, we do believe gold financiers are currently well positioned versus competition, because primary competition in the form of personal loans and microfinance has dried up. Now, if we look at the various parts of the market, mid caps and financials have lagged on the upside. While Nifty is just about 8% away from its peak, the BSE Finance Index is over 25% away, and BankEx is over 30% away from the peak. With the economy opening up and normalizing, and also with this space seeing strong fundraising to take care of bad loans and future growth, we do believe that this space could participate much better in the future. Similarly, spaces in mid caps which could win in the future and do well, especially spaces which tend to be benefited by increasing import duties or by the government's production linked incentive plans. Our portfolios reflect overall an asset allocation of 30% financials, with 10% into insurance, 30% into consumers, broadly speaking, 5% into cement. That's our call on the capex side. We believe cement is the best manner of playing that. 10% in chemicals, 10% in pharmaceuticals, including CRAMS and APIs. And diagnostic chains, 5 to 10% in autos and ancillaries, 5% in agri, and 5 to 10% in other ideas across our portfolios. We continue to focus on cash on book businesses, free cash flow generating businesses, high quality management with a strong sustained growth outlook as always. Thank you. Happy investing.